Alyssa, what's on your radar?
So something wonderful happened earlier this week. Amidst the horrible headlines of devastation in Afghanistan and rising COVID rates around the country, one good piece of news crawled across our televisions. Andrew Cuomo had formally resigned from office, and New York had its first ever female governor. But even in his departure, arguably the most arrogant man on the planet, Governor Cuomo, was defiant.
But the truth will out in time. Of that, I am confident.
The truth is, Andrew Cuomo went out of office like he spent most of his time in it, lying. In a rather remarkable act of transparency, newly sworn in New York Governor Kathy Hochul released updated COVID-19 death numbers on her first day in office. They revealed 12,000 more deaths than previously disclosed by outgoing Governor Cuomo, bringing the total in New York up to 55,000 deaths. To repeat, that's up 12,000 from roughly 43,000 that Governor Cuomo had reported to the public on his very last day in office. Now, we already knew Andrew Cuomo is kind of horrible. You'll recall his abysmal handling of COVID, allowing more than 10,000 senior citizens to die in New York nursing homes. You knew he wrote a book on his leadership while the pandemic was still raging and New Yorkers were dying. You knew he accepted an Emmy for his press briefings, something most normal people would consider simply doing one's job. You also have, in all likelihood, read the horrible headlines documenting systematic abuse, sexual harassment, and bullying of women. Gross. But what you may have not known is that Cuomo's terribleness extends beyond his treatment of humans and on to man's best friend. Earlier this week, reports came to light that Governor Gropey had left the governor's mansion after formally resigning his post on Monday, but had left behind something very important: his dog, Captain. According to the Albany Times Union, two state police sources said that the governor had recently asked mansion staff members if anyone would be interested in adopting the dog. Vanity Fair ran a headline that read, "In the last act as governor, Andrew Cuomo appears to abandon dog at Albany Mansion. Cuomo reportedly ditched the pooch after taking off for his sister's house in Westchester." Seriously? Uproar ensued among dog lovers far and wide. How heartless could one be to abandon a family dog? Well, about as heartless as a guy who profited off of a pandemic by writing a book, I suppose. Now, New York Congresswoman Claudia Tenney tweeted, quote, "In case you needed any more proof that Andrew Cuomo was a narcissistic sociopath, he just abandoned his dog at the governor's mansion. I'd be happy to adopt Captain into my, quote, cuteness pack. I join the Congresswoman's sentiment and would be happy to adopt Captain Cuomo, assuming my fiancé is on board." Now, even the New York State Animal Protection Federation released a statement expressing that it was willing and eager to help Captain Cuomo. Even better, Janice Dean, Fox News reporter and full-time nemesis of Andrew Cuomo, offered to take in Captain Cuomo as well, saying he deserved a loving family. Now, Andrew Cuomo pushed back on the reports that he abandoned his beloved family pet, saying they were false. He tweeted, "Some people just can't get the facts straight." However, ABC News smartly noted that the picture posted by Governor Cuomo with Captain was in fact from 2020, an old photo, raising questions about where Captain Cuomo currently is. It's official. I'm a Captain Cuomo truther. Now, usually I would give someone the benefit of the doubt against allegations of being a horrible, dog-abandoning human being. But this is Andrew Cuomo, after all. The man who put senior citizen COVID patients in nursing homes to die. The same guy who wrote a book congratulating himself on what a good job he had done beating COVID while it ravaged his state. The man who accepted an Emmy for literally doing his job, giving the public updates on the coronavirus. And finally, this is a man who systematically abused and harassed female staff. I don't know about you, but this sounds to me like a guy who might abandon man's best friend and try to get away with it by posting an old picture. Captain Cuomo, you deserve better. And you honestly probably would have been a better governor than your human.
I mean, this is horrible. Who abandons their dog? First of all, the dog is beautiful. I'm a dog lover. I have a big, beautiful dog, just like Captain Cuomo. The dog needs a name change first, right away. But I mean, this is like, you know, when Trump, when he got into the White House and he was like the first guy to not have a dog or something, and that kind of said something about his character. And I really think if you don't love animals or if you're going to just abandon your pets, I don't know. I have a real hard time with that. My pets are rescues.
It's the biggest red flag. Totally agree. Yeah. Anyone who's not an animal lover, it is a huge red flag. Ryan.
And then there's Ryan over here. He's probably like, I hate animals.
I love dogs. Love cats, too, even. The timing of it is also absurd. You know, Harry Truman famously said, if you want a friend in Washington, get a dog. And there's something profound in that, on both ends of that comment. And Cuomo desperately needed a friend in that moment. To turn on the only person that would unquestionably, you know, welcome him back as he came home. Like, why? Because he was going to go to a luxury condo that doesn't allow dogs? I mean, what even is he thinking here?
Yeah, his priorities have been very skewed from the outset of this. But I would note today's actually National Dog Day, so I hope that Captain finds a home with a loving family.
With a new name.
Cap'n. Just call him Cap'n.
Cap'n.
Yeah.
And Ryan, we're looking forward to your radar next.